हेलो वंस अगेन ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ संत गाडगे बाबा अमरावती यूनिवर्सिटी अमरावती आई वेलकम टू द ऑल व्यूअर्स ऑन द यूट्यूब लाइव स्ट्रीमिंग सो हियर वी प्रेजेंट द awareness webinar once again on behalf of Santa Garbi Baba Amravati University
Hardish program Bagule sir
yes
ha chalu kara karyakram chalu
kela na
ha
for this webinar we have chairman honorable pro vice chancellor dr rajesh ji jaipurkar sir
नमस्कार
इस्टीम प्रेजेंस ऑफ रिस्पेक्टेड डीन फैकल्टी साइंस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी डॉक्टर रघुवंशी सर एंड डायरेक्टर इनोवेशन इनक्यूबेशन एंड लिंकेजेस डॉक्टर डीटी इंगोले सर फॉर दिस वेबिनार प्रोग्राम वी हैव द इमिनेंट पर्सनैलिटी advisor of Rajiv Gandhi Science and Technology Mumbai Dr. Pragati Gokhale madam with us and here my colleague and organizing secretary of this program Mr. Vikrant Malviya deputy registrar development so our university is organizing a webinar on Rajiv Gandhi Science and Technology scheme assistance for science and technology application through university system this live streaming will be on youtube live and this RGSTC scheme that is a Rajiv Gandhi science and technology scheme is to spread project activity and extend research culture to smaller institutions or colleges the commission is implementing a scheme through the university network project of short duration and linked to local resources skills problems and development needs are implemented through university the proposal that is a pre proposal should establish the linkages of science and technology application to overall development of the state for this we conduct this awareness webinar to the all affiliated colleges of Sant Gaadge Baba Amravati University Amravati to start this program for free space I request director innovation incubation and linkages dr dt ingole sir please start the free space regarding this awareness webinar please dr dt ingole sir sir please your mic is off sir but please on your mic english sir
thank you
sir
chairman of today's webinar head of the RGSTC scheme at SGBAU dr rajesh ji jaipurkar sir our honorable pro vc of Sant Gaadge Baba Amravati university today's eminent speaker dr Pragati Gokhale madam, who is advisor of RGSTC Nagpur, Dr. F.C. Raghuvanshi sir, honorable dean of science and technology at SGBAU, Dr. Sandeep Vagule sir, who is a member secretary of this RGSTC scheme at SGBAU, my colleague Mr. Malviya, Deputy Registrar Development, HGBU. Respected principals, faculties, students, and all attendees of this webinar, ladies and gentlemen. At the outset, I welcome all of you for this webinar of RGSTC scheme, Assistance for Science and Technology Application through University System. So we must congratulate the leader of the scheme, Dr. Rajesh Jaipurkar sir. Because of his effort, we have received the huge grant from the RGSTC for this scheme. So I am Dr. D.T. Ingole. I am the Director of Innovation, Incubation and Linkages. And as per the instruction, I am presenting my webinar through PowerPoint presentation. So friends, this Rajiv Gandhi Science and Technology Commission, which is popularly named as RGSTC, has a set up under the government of Maharashtra as a statutory body under the Maharashtra Act number 15, 2004. And the main purpose is the advancement, propagation and the promotion of applications of science and technology for the benefit of the students and the people. The objectives of this commission is displayed here. The main objective of this commission, RGSTC, is act as an agent. They act as a propagator and they act as a catalyst also. So being an agent, the RGSTC is responsible to provide the change and development or advancement to the inputs of the science and technology. They also propagate the applications of science and technology through the studies, the adoption of technology, the formulating projects using the technology, the field of demonstrations, imparting necessary training, publications, consultancy, all they are propagating. They also act as a catalyst, which is very important application. They facilitate the transfer technology from the laboratories and other research efforts to application of science and technology on a large scale. I would like to emphasize particularly this objective is very important for the science and engineering and technology faculties and the students, where the science and technology and engineering people are publishing their projects in a large extent. And through this research, they can transfer their technology to industries, any companies, so that apart from that research activity, they could able to gain the lot of financial assistance from the industry as well as other aspect also. So therefore, this transfer of technology aspect, which I found very important for the science and technology fraternity. This RGSTC is particularly emphasized on applications which are socio-economic development. As you know that this study is not only meant for within the wall of the classrooms, that is to be extended to the all the socio-economic development. So with that purpose, they emphasize particularly application of science and technology so that every human being can benefit it. This activity is need to be undertaken in a projects mode with a very clear targets and time-bound frames for implementation, so that the purpose of development of that project should be very crystal and clear. The RGSTC also expected through the existing institutions, depending on their expertise, capabilities, interest, facilities, and all about. Obviously, such institution are including not only the university or the colleges, but they also include the very special laboratories also, then engineering institution already has said, the NGOs also, because NGOs role also very important in a socio-economic development, then the various field of agencies of the government also there, which are important for enhancement of the socio-economic development. So they are also part and parcel of this development. This RGSTC is also invited the proposals for innovative applications of science and technology. So here one should understand very clearly that this program should not be a very regular one. There should be some innovation into that, so that that innovation is going to be helpful for the socio-economic development. And this is the one of the main purpose of this invitation. This application could be linked to the various aspect, for example, the material resources, then there could be any specific problem also, and certain potential for development also. So you can pick up any particular area on the basis of this. This activity can be area specific or the sector specific. Here I'd like to give the more explanation regarding these two. For example, the area specific, as you know that there are a particular area where we are staying, for example, where we are locating. So obviously in that location, there may be a specific problem the particular people are facing. So we can understand that problem, pick up that problem, and depend on that problem, you can have the project. Similarly, you can have the sector specific also, whether you want to go for any management, water management part, or for example, livelihood or the energy conservation, all these are the sector specific. So you can pick up the any particular project based on this sector specific. So therefore your project should be on the basis of these two activity. One of the example I will quote hereafter also, that our institution has developed one project based on the Bell Ghat, which is the very area specific one. Or one of the project is on the basis of the Lonar development. So that is area specific as well as the sector specific like that. Similarly, this RGSTC also invite the specific projects proposals for consideration under this scheme. The main purpose of this scheme, where the scheme is the proposal is a peer review, and when these proposals are found to be useful, the RGSTC will provide, of course, the very necessary logistic support or the financial support for implementation of such a project, which is the ultimate aim of the today's webinar. The general guidelines for this formulation of this project is also we'll discuss in this webinar. Very clear and very simple guidelines they are providing. This project format is also prescribed by the RGSTC. So we have to fill up only that format and submit to the RGSTC. That is that simple. So that may be discussed in today's webinar. So in the project, about how the, what should be the nature of this project for support of under the RGSTC application program, that I'd like to explain here within two, three slides. The first about this project should be may be based on studies and surveys. I think as we belong to the science and technology people, so we know that there are various projects which is based on the specific studies and the surveys. So that can be a project which can include under this scheme. So that may be the techno-economic analysis or for technology purpose, that can be a simulation modeling. That all these are the part and parcel of this scheme. Similarly, as you know that every state government has their own databases. So likewise in the Maharashtra also, all the departments has their own databases, because most of the departments are now the digitized. So these databases can be used as a resources, and you can develop your project based on that. Similarly, the science and technology policy issues can be also project, and the project can be based on the technology gaps also. As you know that the technologies are growing day by day, but in a specific area, if the technology is used in a very old way, we may propose the newly technology based on that, and so that the technology gap can be reduced. The best example, we may say that in engineering particularly, some of the industries, they are using the very old technology. So with this new technology, one may implement the automation, say low cost automation to the engineering that industry. So that with implementation of that low cost automation, the industry can grow up to the new extent. So likewise, so such a project can be the part of this scheme. The activities under this head should lead to the specific action plan for generation of the field project also. Another nature of this project can be a location specific research and technology development. As already explained to you that location means the area. So we can identifying the S&T program or the development oriented location specific research and technology development. So wherever we are locating, your institute is locating, that problems we can find out, and based on that problem we can place a particular project. So that is the very good options for the socio-economic development. Similarly, we may have the pilot scale demonstration project also, where the central government agencies, then the laboratories and institutions, they have the various field trials based on the technology. So based on that also we can put a project. So that could be a pilot scale demonstration project. Then the replication of the successful models can be also your project. Replication in the sense, as you aware that some of the projects are only successful in a particular area or particular zone. So while studying that, you may pick up that similar project and you may implement in your area also. So that can also possible. If you find any project is very successful at Marathwada region, yes. And if that is successful in that region, you may pick up that same application and you may try to implement in your region also. I mean, like that. Just like as you aware that Jal Shivar is a sort of a project the earlier government had developed, which was very successful, which might have developed in any specific area. But after that moment, the fellows could understand that could develop to the very successful way, they had developed that and propagate that to all the areas like that. So that can be possible. So the replication of the successful model can be also important. The joint program is a very good concept, we may say. You might have heard about the Triple P programs like that, where the people's and public participations, they are expected. Similarly, in the joint program, if you heard about Unnat Bharat Abhiyan particularly, where we had taken the various villages, and with that Dattak villages, we could able to find out the various problems in that villages. But naturally, as the problems are in the villages, the person or the students from the institute cannot lonely perform the projects in that institute at the villages. So therefore, they can take the help from the all the villagers as well as the all the stakeholders from the villages like that. So that with the joint collaborative project, they can complete that project. Similarly, various the NGOs are also there. Then the state councils are also there. You might have heard about one of the very good project earlier government had started, which is called a CM fellow, where that CM fellow person has to stay at village, and that fellow has to study all the problems of the village, and after studying that problem, that CM fellow has to submit that problems to the authority, that is the collector of that concerned city, and through the collector, that problems is disseminated to all the NGOs or whomsoever they could develop to find out the solution on that need-based problems like that. So there is somebody like a CM fellow who is looking after to find out the problems like that. So after understanding that need-based problems, the various agencies can involve and find out the solutions. So that thing can be also the part of the project of this. So here the joint program is everybody in a joint venture, they can find out the solutions of the problems, which is very good aspect of this solution. Then the awareness and training is very regular concept, as everybody is aware of this. So awareness and training of a specific technology can be propagated through this scheme. So this is about the particular one. Here I'd like to explain this, how this RGSTC scheme is going to be helpful for all of us. So this is a very good example that our institution HGBU already is working in collaboration with the RGSTC. Is one of the only two programs I could display here. Otherwise, there are a lot of programs. You just look at the title of the projects and total cost of this. So RGSTC has sanctioned this program, which is an inexpensive method for the determination of the oxalate in a urine and the assessment of the hyperoxia of the nano-based paper strip technique, which is a very good concept for extraction of the knowledge of this. So for that very innovative project, the RGSTC has sanctioned 35 lakhs for this. This project is still undergoing. Similarly, there is a process development and the characterization of the anti-erotic activities of the bioactive metabolic of selected medicinal plants. I would like to have your attention here. This is for the Melghat forest region. I just quoted there, area specific like that. So here you can study any particular area and you can develop the project based on that. For example, in the Melghat, there is also problem on the malnutrition. So therefore your department may develop a certain solution on the malnutrition, and that could be also a project like that. So this is one of the projects where the RGSTC has sanctioned 28 lakhs for that, and this is already completed. So very eminent personalities, the teachers and the researcher from our AHGVU, those we had sanctioned. This is Dr. Anita Patil Madam, then Dr. Dhanarte Madam, P.V. Thakre, then Kamble, Dr. Kamble, all these eminent researchers could get this funding from the RGSTC. So this is all about preamble of this scheme, which I had explained you. If the time permit, we may explain the particular pro forma, if it is possible. This is the address of the RGSTC. And these are the concerned person, funding, then the correspondence, and the pre-proposals, which is to be admitted at our RGSTC. So we will get this all this information from the Dr. Wagule in detail afterward also. So the guidelines and the format may be discussed afterward if the time permits. So this is about the preamble of this scheme. I would like to add one more part in this explanation. That's
hello.
All these projects. Yes, sir.
Okay.
Okay.
Yeah.
So all these projects can be developed under the as a startup. Under the startup, as you know that the innovation incubation cell is developed, is established in Amaravati University. So therefore, your project can also be linked with this, so that your project cannot be only the part of the completion of this project, but can be a startup, so that you can develop your entrepreneur activity through that also. So I appeal all the honorable principals and faculties and the students to please consider and you put your projects under this assistance for the S&T so that we can get all the benefits. So I'm thankful to honorable Dr. Rajesh Jaipurkar sir for giving me this opportunity to speak with you. Thank you very much. Thank you sir
for giving valuable information regarding the proposals and societal benefits and information about our university. Thank you sir. On behalf of our university, I request all the researchers, all the participants who are in live YouTube streaming, please put up your questions, queries on the chat box so that our dignitaries will be respond through this live streaming. So I humbly request all the viewers, please put up your questions and queries on the chat box of the YouTube. So now, before we are going to talk of our today's advisor, Dr. Pragati Gokhale Madam, first of all, let me introduce Dr. Gokhale Madam. Madam has around 40 years of rich experience in multiple disciplines, namely statistics, ICT, e-governance, ERP, entrepreneurship development, digital marketing, rural development, data sciences. She is the founder and chief mentor for Mission Mera Mobile Mera Marketing, which is a disruptive bottom-up approach for enabling completely free online agro and rural marketing in India from rural stakeholders. She retired as deputy director in December 2018 from Mahatma Gandhi Institute of Rural Industrialization, a national institute under the government of India, Ministry of Micro, Small and Medium Enterprises. She is now working as an advisor to the Rajiv Gandhi Science and Technology Commission, Government of Maharashtra, Mumbai, and Department of Science and Technology Seed Program, Government of India, since last 2 years. She is also the National Resource Person by Ministry of Rural Development, Government of India. With this, such eminent personality, we have for the our awareness webinar. So I request Dr. Pragati Gokhale Madam, please, to start your presentation for this webinar.
Sir, am I audible?
Yeah.
Good afternoon, one and all. And I first congratulate Honorable Vice Chancellor, Amravati University, Pro VC, Director Innovation, and Vagole sir for getting this one-time university grant scheme from Rajiv Gandhi Science and Technology Commission to Amravati University along with Nagpur University. So sir, Ingoli sir has already covered many things in my presentation. So we will go to my presentation at the end, which you can show. First, I want to speak on certain aspects. So Ingoli sir has given a very comprehensive presentation, but I think there should not be some confusion. That is why I am going to clear two aspects. That is, one thing is that today we are talking about two science and technology schemes for funding by Rajiv Gandhi Science and Technology Commission, which are available to all the eminent professors, researchers of the Amravati University. One is, you can directly apply to Rajiv Gandhi Science and Technology Commission for funding for the projects which are above this university grant scheme. Because in university grant scheme, this is the grant which we have given to Amravati University is 50 lakhs, and under this grant, you will be granted small projects. Maximum project amount that you will budget, you will get is 5 lakhs. So for the big projects, if you have something innovative and something big in the mind, like that Anita Patil Madam's project, you can directly write to Rajiv Gandhi Science and Technology Commission. And that email address is also there on rgstc.maharashtra.gov.in. And a complete proposal, you have to first send a pre-proposal. There is a generally meeting after 6 to 8 months. And after that meeting, you will get a confirmation that your pre-proposal is approved and you are asked to submit a detailed proposal with the budget, with the budget details and everything. So that funding scheme goes through various stages. First, you have to submit your pre-proposal. Then there will be a meeting of a project approval committee. Then it will go to committee of peers, then committee of experts. And finally, you will get sanctioned. That will take around 1 year roughly. But the project amount you will get if your project is sanctioned is quite big as compared to this one-time university grant scheme. This one, and actually some of the professors and some of the researchers in your university are already taking benefit of this. Secondly, this one-time grant for Amravati University scheme, we are starting from this year only, and under which proposals are invited from all of you under various things. And now I want to clarify certain things, because the Ingoli sir has also shown, and you must have also received in your email the details about what type of proposals should be sent. But please understand, please understand that we are here looking for science and three things. Science and technology intervention means input from your side, because you are all that way scientists. Science and technology intervention and input from your side. Secondly, we want some innovation. Thirdly, innovation may be in the process, not even in the product. Innovation. And thirdly, it should have societal benefit. And concrete deliverable should be given in your project proposals in both the stages, here and also in the big projects also. So though we have written, because it is somewhat old pro forma, we have written surveys and training and awareness programs, the commission is no more funding such typical things. And in training and awareness programs, lot many organizations are funding. So this is not a mandate of Rajiv Gandhi Science and Technology Commission. We are here looking for really some interventions, some inputs, and which will benefit some societal problems based on local resources, local areas. It may be anything. Surveys and surveys are okay, but there should not be just surveys and database given. It should be supplemented with proper modeling. There are various technologies now, artificial intelligence models you can also develop. Some gadgets you can develop based on surveys. Right now there are, last week only, we have completed Nagpur University second meeting rather. We have received the similar scheme for Nagpur University. We have received 180 proposals. We sat with the Vice Chancellor and firstly we shortlisted it to 60 proposals, and then again shortlisting, 40 proposals were called for PowerPoint presentation. And we have now selected around 8 to 10 projects from them. So please understand that this is a cutthroat competition, that koi bhi project kahi bhi chal raha hai, utha ke yahan laga diya, aisa nahi chalega. We will definitely see for some input from your side, from science and technology intervention from your side, because you have that capacity, and that is why the scheme is implemented through university, because you are having the latest knowledge and latest research in your field. So that should benefit society. That is the main purpose. And some innovation should be also there. So though it is a small project, suppose, because you may say that it is just a maximum limit is 5 lakhs, but if the project is successful, it can be taken ahead with the next funding scheme of RGSTC or any other funding scheme. If the project is successful, it has some deliverables, then it can be taken to any heights that you and me know. So please look for from that angle for this science and technology scheme, which is implemented to Amravati University. It is my humble submission to all. PowerPoint presentation I just avoided, because it will be a replication of what Dr. Ingole has given, and everything is available on RGSTC website also. But just I wanted to clarify among that there should not be confusion about RGSTC University Grant Scheme and RGSTC Science and Technology Funding Scheme, which is available to all, like NGOs also can apply for it, researchers can apply for it, institutions can apply for it, professors can apply for it. That is a big funding scheme. And here it is restricted to colleges coming under science and technology related colleges coming under Amravati University. That is a difference. And here the funding amount is also low. And I will be in the committee as a RGSTC nominee, and rest other honorable dignitaries from Amravati University will take forward this scheme, and we will look that very good proposals we will receive, like we have received in the Nagpur University, certain innovations, certain societal problems. Now the healthcare is also a big team coming ahead in on the background of Corona. So please see that there should be some innovation, there should be some deliverables, and there must be some science and technology intervention and input from your side, not just a replication or not just a survey. So this is my input, and we all are now open for any question and answers. So Vagale sir, just go through my presentation. Vagale sir.
Yes madam.
Presentation dikha do aap, and then we will take question and answers. So everything is clear there, nothing is to be explained in it. One of the the big scheme, assistance for S&T applications, and guidelines and format for submission of proposals is also on the website.
Okay, ma'am.
Science popularization and science education that we are conducting National Science Day. Last year only I was invited for National Science Day at Amravati University. The theme was, I think, scientist, woman scientist or something like that. Cherekar madam has invited me.
Yeah.
And I had a quiet discussion with Shalika sir also. These are the general guidelines for formulating proposals, and which here also in our small scheme, university funding scheme, you can also follow these guidelines. Next. Please avoid it because it is for the seed program, DST seed program. If anybody wants any guidance regarding that also, for Rural Women Technology Park, I am there on their project advisor committee, so I can also guide on that. One science innovation activity center is also sanctioned by and is also running successfully in Amravati by RGSTC. I think it is by Shivaji Education Society. So Amravati has a very long relationship with RGSTC, and now we are taking it ahead with this one-time university grad scheme. And it is not necessary, even next year also you will get this funding for, and every year you can get this funding if we can implement this program successfully and have some deliverables. So any question and answers?
Okay madam.
Vagule sir. Let us begin question answer session. If okay. You have any question.
Okay sir. Now we go to the questions that are put up by the webinar viewers on YouTube. Now the question asked by Rachana Pachuri. Sir, can we take JRF under this scheme, and whether he or she can be awarded PhD degree on the same project?
Yes, one minute. Very nice question. Very nice question. Under university grant scheme, generally you can't outsource anything. You have to do it yourself. For the big thing, that is why I very clearly mentioned that there are two schemes. One is completely under your university, but there you cannot outsource, and there you have to do work along with your research student, but you cannot pay and all that. And also, secondly, we can pay for equipments and all, but for not casual things like laptop. That is also avoided. Laptop, nahi to bahut log laptop hi mang lete. So genuinely required equipments and materials that we are funding, but not for outsourcing. Because Nagpur University mein bhi aisa hua tha ki R&D ka jo kaam tha, yani some sort of analysis and all. They were an outsourcing. So that is not possible under this.
Yeah. The question is whether GRF is allowed under this scheme.
No. Yeah. Under university scheme, not allowed.
That is the question. Yeah.
The under university scheme not allowed, but allowed under the big scheme, which schemes I have told, the direct application to Rajiv Gandhi.
Yeah, okay.
Under that scheme, it is allowed.
Under this scheme, that is assistance for science and technology application through
university scheme.
GRF is not allowed.
Yes.
That is very clear.
Yes,
yeah. Then another question is there from Dr. Dinesh Khedkar. Wagule, sir.
Yes, madam. Another question is, what will be the process of evaluation for the project at the university level? Is there any specific parameters?
Yeah, that I have already told now. We are looking for science and technology input, interventions from your side. Because we want something from your side input, not just a replication, not just a survey, and innovation. And we will look after the what you will deliver. We will ask you to give, when you are shortlisted, we will ask you to present it in 4 or 5 slides at the time of final presentation. What will be your deliverables? What will be, what will beneficiaries will get? What is your methodology? And what is the intervention you are doing from your end?
Okay, madam.
And one good input was there from Director Innovation also, Ingole sir, that if we take this some deliverables we get, then we can think of in taking this ahead through incubation center also.
Yeah.
That big madam, type of funding we will get afterwards.
Yeah. Okay, madam. Madam, another question is from electronics developers. They written as, we are not part of HGBU Amravati University. Can we participate in this funding?
University funding is available only to the colleges affiliated to Amravati University.
Amravati University.
But the second key, which I have told you, for the bigger funding is available to you, please apply to Rajiv Gandhi Science and Technology Commission site, assistance for science and technology interventions.
One thing I want to add, Dr. Dinesh Khedkar has categorically asked the process of evaluation. I want to tell one thing that as per the guidelines, we have a committee of peers.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
And that committee of peers will evaluate the project, the idea, and the concept.
Honorable Vice Chancellor will decide a committee from Amravati University end, and I will be there as a nominee from RGSTC side. So the committee will be decided by Honorable Vice Chancellor for evaluation of the projects. I will be only there as a nominee from RGSTC side for evaluating the projects.
Okay, anything else? Any question?
Yes, another question is from Dr. Dinesh Khedkar, sir. How this can help to SEAC working under Sri Shivaji Education Society, Amravati?
Yeah, another thing I want to clear.
Yeah.
This particular system, this scheme is meant for only full-time regular teachers.
Okay.
That is very clear. So, GRF is not allowed, and any other entity like SISC is also not allowed. Only full-time teacher can apply through the head of the institution.
Yes, sir. Another question I request to dignitaries. The question is from Prashant B. Kharat. He said, sir, can we submit multiple projects in the same scheme by the same faculty?
Yeah, you can.
Yeah, yeah. That is allowed.
That is allowed. And actually, in DST also, we look at if some areas are very, very remote and they are submitting somewhat good project, then it should be encouraged, because it helps college there and faculties there and students there.
Yeah.
from the remote areas of Melghat and all that.
Okay, okay. Another question is from Prashant Taide. He said, my project is needed higher funding. Is it possible into this scheme? No. Near about 15 lakhs?
No, then you have to go for that scheme. Otherwise, yeah, you can do one thing. You can submit a project, take somewhat funding from this scheme and other funding from other CSR or other activities. That that type of proposals has been submitted to Nagpur University by some Raisoni professors also. So they have arranged remaining funding. It was some in healthcare, IoT in healthcare project it was.
Another question is from Dr. Nitin Khandare. He said, whether any preference for selection of project topic on related to tribal community or tribal region?
Definitely, if it is having a measurable societal impact, the projects having measurable societal impact, innovation and S&T intervention from the project jo put kar raha hai unse agar hai, then there will be a preferential. And tribal is of course society's bottom of pyramid portion, so definitely.
Okay, madam.
But the project should be some innovation or some, not just training and awareness.
Okay, madam. Another question.
No training and awareness project will be sanctioned under this scheme.
Okay, madam. Another question is from Dr. Dilip Hande. He said, what about funding limit of the research project?
Maximum 5 lakhs.
Maximum 5 lakhs.
Under university scheme.
Okay.
And under open scheme, it can be 50 to 60 lakhs also.
Okay. The questions one.
But all of you are aware. And we all are aware that this year funding scenario is somewhat not that bright. So
okay.
this is a good opportunity that you have got this scheme. Because even DST has curtailed certain funding schemes also.
Sir, there is
only for this year.
Yeah, madam. Okay. Another questions from Professor Suresh Kavitkar. I request the Dean, Faculty of Science and Technology, please focus on this question, sir. Is it available for MBA course? Do you consider MBA as a science and technology? I request the response from Dean, Faculty of Science and Technology. Yeah. Sir, Raghuji sir, mic off hai.
Dr. Kavitkar.
Yes.
This scheme is applicable or available for the full-time teacher from engineering college, pharmacy college and science college, not from or the MBA courses. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you, sir. Another question from Professor Jasmir Kaur B. Randhawa. She said, how much time it takes for the grant of proposal? How much time it take for grant of proposal?
So, I want to answer this question. We have given 3 months for submission of pre-proposals. So 19th January will be the
last date
for submission of pre-proposal. And after that, within 1.5 months, ek te did mahinya madhe, we will be finalizing the pre-proposals. Then the selected proposals will be called for the detailed proposals. And after submission of detailed proposal, we may give 1 month time for submission of detailed proposal, and then it will take another 1 month. So now from this date, we may be having 3 or 4 months for the finalization of the proposals.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir. Hope that all the viewers may satisfied for this response from our dignitaries. Now, we...
Any question? Any other question, sir?
No more questions, sir, from the viewers. So, we proceed to the next as a presidential speech. So today,
let us ask Raghunji sir.
Yeah.
Dr. F.C. Raghunji sir, Dean.
Yeah.
Do you want sir. To add something more?
Sir, it is sufficient.
It is sufficient. Okay.
Yes, it is sufficient.
Adhyaksha Mahoday.
Bola sir, bola.
Thank you, sir. Again, sir, Ashi ahe. जी आपल्या याच्यातून थोडी सांगण्यात नाही आली की एक आपलं पेटंट सुद्धा याच्यामध्ये पेंडिंग आहे आरजीएसटीची ही अतिशय गर्वाची आणि अभिमानाची गोष्ट आहे. नुसतं प्रोजेक्टच नाही तर आपण पेटंट सुद्धा
व्हेरी इम्पॉर्टंट. येस
येस सर. थँक्यू.
थँक्स फॉर ऍडिंग दिस.
ओके सर. So we are going to the presidential speech. So today's president of this awareness program, our honorable Pro Vice Chancellor Dr. Rajesh ji Jaipurkar sir, I request sir for the presidential speech.
Thank you. At the outset, being chairman of this awareness webinar, I welcome all the dignitaries, particularly Dr. Prabhu, madam, with the advisor from Rajiv Gandhi Technology Commission, my colleague in the campus, Dean Science and Technology, Dr. F.C. Raghunji sir, Director Innovation and Incubation and Linkages, Dr. D.T. Ingole sir, Mr. Malviyaji, Deputy Registrar, Development Section, then coordinator of this esteemed scheme, Dr. Sandeep Paguleji, all the principals from the affiliated colleges, heads of the university departments, and the participants, teachers. Good afternoon to one and all. Namaskar. Friends, this is the very nice opportunity for all of us, for all teachers. We know from last 3-4 years, we don't have any research funds from the external agencies. So we don't have research mobilization funds. Now, this is the scheme where we are providing 5 lakhs per project, per idea, per concept. So this is important. Another thing, this scheme is exclusively for regular teachers from science, technology, pharmacy, and cosmetic technology departments, from affiliated colleges and university departments. So we have 50 lakhs in hand. So we can fund 10 or 12 projects out of this assistance scheme. My dear friends, we all know that Rajiv Gandhi Science and Technology Commission is a government of Maharashtra enterprise. And this commission is particularly set up for advancement, propagation and promotion of application of science and technology. So we have a MOU. Sant Gadge Baba Amravati University is having a MOU with RGSTC for this particular scheme. The name of the scheme is Assistance for Science and Technology Applications Through University System. And now Rajiv Gandhi Science and Technology Commission wants to propagate this scheme through university system up to the affiliated colleges. So this is a very nice chance for all of us. My dear friends, 19th January is the last date for submission of pre-proposals. There is a, as earlier said, we have a committee of peers Honorable Vice Chancellor is the chairman of this committee, and there are near about 12 to 13 members, including industrial representatives and senior professors, researchers, etc. And then after a detailed scrutiny, there will be finalization of pre-proposal, and that proposals will be selected for detailed proposals. So this is the process, and this will be completed within 6 months maximum. And we have given 6 broad areas of research as stated, as explained by Dr. D.T. Ingole sir and Dr. Pragati Gokhale madam. Another thing is there that we have published these guidelines on university website under the head news and advertisement. Then there are some general terms and conditions. Then second thing, we have given illustrative list of project and project areas for new proposals. That is important. काही मार्गदर्शक यादी आपण या ठिकाणी दिलेली आहे, and that can be useful for selection of the particular topic. So likewise, we have water, nutrition, energy. These are the sectors covered under this list. Then we have given the pro forma for pre-proposal, pro forma for biodata of the investigators. Then comes the pro forma for proposal in detail. That is the second phase also. So we have given the pro formas also. And these pro formas are to be submitted through the head of the institution, means from the principal or head of the university departments. So this is what we have for you people. So I once again welcome you all, and we expect a bumper response from your side. This is again, I will say, a good opportunity for all researchers. And so I welcome all of you, and also thankful to you for having with all of us in this awareness webinar. Thank you. Namaskar.
Thank you. Thank you, sir, for your valuable suggestion and for your valuable guidance. Sir, there is one question from Professor Gopal Dhokne. One question. The question is that, sir, please send details regarding the proposal.
Okay. We have already mailed the guidelines and formats for this scheme to all the principals. Another thing is, we have these guidelines on university website under the heading news and advertisement. And lastly, we are again sending the guidelines with all formats to all colleges within 8 days. Puna ekda second sathi pathvanar aahe. Okay.
Okay, okay, sir. Thank you. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Last but not the least, we are going to the vote of thanks. So I request our Deputy Registrar Development, please deliver the vote of thanks to this webinar.
Good afternoon, everyone. Thank you all for sparing your precious time and for such knowledgeable session. Surely there is a lot to take away from such interaction, and we are quite sure that we will be getting good responses for the said project. I would like to thank Honorable Chairman of this webinar, Dr. Jaipurkar sir, Honorable Pro VC sir, Honorable Dean, Science and Technology, Dr. F.C. Raghuvanshi sir, Dr. Pragati Gokhale madam, RGSTC advisor and resource person for this webinar. I would like to thank Director Innovation and Incubation, Dr. D.T. Ingole sir, convener of this webinar, Dr. Vaghuve sir, and all principals of this affiliated to this university and their coordinators, head of departments of Sant Gadge Baba University. And I would like to, I hereby announce that today's webinar is concluded with the permission of Honorable Chairman.
Thank you, sir. Once again, I request all the viewers, if you have any questions or query, please email, which is given on the letterhead to the all the principals of the affiliated colleges. Thank you, sir. With the permission of the chair, the today's awareness webinar is over.
Thank you.
Namaskar, madam.
Thank you very much.
Namaskar.